All right. Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Ramirez, Director of Medical School Tutoring at MedSchoolCoach. Just wanted to reach out to you guys, say a few things kind of in the current situation of the COVID-19 outbreak, and then also talk about what kind of implications this is going to have on you preparing for your medical school exams and all of these really important board exams that are coming up and that some of you might be planning to take soon. So first off, to kind of address the outbreak, I think things are kind of rapidly developing kind of day to day. Things are changing a lot. No one really knows exactly how things are going to change in a few weeks or a couple of months from now, but they have every day new things are coming out, and I'll be able to address a few of those. The first is, as this virus spreads and has an impact on our lives and kind of the way we live our lives, and particularly as students, how we go through education, I just really want to emphasize that I'm wishing you all the best and hope that you're all being safe and that your lives are, I guess, minimally disrupted by this disturbance. So these kind of evolutions are changing day to day. So whatever I talk about today might be different by the time tomorrow comes. But what I'll do is I'll kind of share with you what is going on right now and kind of how we're thinking about this and how you potentially could adapt as a student. So due to the outbreak, the medical schools are really changing their curriculum. So most preclinical classes have now been canceled, or I guess not so much canceled, but switched to kind of a digital medium. So from my knowledge, most of the schools across the country are now kind of putting a pause on any kind of lectures, and all the small group activities are now happening digitally. I think that what they're going to do as far as exams still remains to be seen. I know at my institution, they are still planning to have people come in to do the exams just to protect security. But I imagine that will probably change, especially because those are big groups of students getting together. I'm sure they'll probably want to avoid that. Released today, March 17th, the AAMC and the LCME issued a guidance to medical schools, essentially formally recommending that they put their clinical rotations on hold until March 31st. So what that means for us is if you're a third or fourth year medical student, your school is likely not going to have you come in for 2 full weeks. What that means as far as your education, what you're going to be required to do at home, how you're going to meet these requirements, it's still really unclear. And it seems like each institution is kind of taking things day by day, and each institution is taking a different approach. But formal recommendation, breaking news today from the AAMC, is pause clinical rotations for at least 2 weeks. And the goal for this is to reduce the potential exposure to medical students, and then also to reduce the use of PPE, personal protective equipment, and kind of reserve it for some of the staff that might need it most, particularly as this moves on, as this develops. Kind of the next really big news is kind of at a federal level in the CDC, they announced recommendations to reduce meetings of greater than 10 people. So in response to that, Prometric actually put essentially a hold and canceled all testing dates until for 30 days starting March 18th, which when I'm recording this is going to be tomorrow. So what that means is also a little unclear. They haven't made it completely clear how they're going to adapt to this. From my understanding, all the testing dates that were scheduled within a month from March 18th will be canceled and likely will be rescheduled to a later date. They mentioned that they're going to waive fees for rescheduling and waive fees for eligibility extension. I don't think there's actually a process in place yet for them to do that, but it's my understanding that that is their plan. So if you had your exams go within 1 month, that will no longer happen. So kind of talking about what that means for you, we'll get to that in a second, but understand that within 1 month, it's not going to happen and you'll likely have to reschedule to a later date. And I think that that is kind of an estimate right now. And I don't think we know if it's going to be only a month or it might be more than a month, but I think we could say it's going to be at least 1 month. So that includes all the STEP exams, all the US, all the COMLEX exams, all put on hold right now. So kind of keeping that in mind, how can you move forward? I mean, I imagine this is a pretty stressful period of time, particularly for people who have been studying for these board exams for weeks, if not months now, are already really stressed about what's going on in the world, what is going on in medical school, and kind of worried about your future. You know, these exams are permanent scores, and in reality, you're going to be stuck with the score for, you know, years to come when we apply to residency. And I don't think that residency programs are just going to accept a, well, you know, it was an outbreak time kind of excuse for a low score. So I think that kind of raises the stress that everybody's having right now. I think what is really important right now is to remain calm, remain focused, and be flexible and adaptable. So, life will move on. You will still be prepared to take these exams, and you're just going to have to rely on kind of different methods. You're going to have to adapt to a new schedule, and you're going to have to focus on more digital learning methods. So if you are someone who was going to in-person class, it's likely that that is canceled. If you like small study groups, you probably should kind of choose a different venue to study. I think more critical than ever is to really focus on digital tutoring and digital education. So here at MedSchoolCoach, we really focus on digital tutoring and digital education. And this is kind of our thing. We've been doing this for years. This is kind of what we specialize in. We provide personalized one-on-one help and one-on-one tutoring. At this period, I think that is extremely important. I think a lot of people are having their study schedules changed last minute. They're kind of having, if you were going to take your exam for the next month, you're going to be rescheduled to a future date that we don't even really know what will be quite yet. So I think it's going to be really important to kind of, first thing first, kind of get back on your feet, reassess kind of the amount of time you're going to have to study, make a study plan, and then begin to enact that study plan. So if you're a preclinical student who's now trying to learn how to be a doctor from home, this is a great time to get some extra help, a great time to get some guidance to someone who's been through it already, and to get a little more directed learning, since a lot of it is now going to be kind of self-directed learning. If you're a clinical student at home, this could be a really great opportunity for you to prepare for the shelf exams, which they're probably still going to have you take, whether that's going to be 2 weeks or later. You'll probably still have to take your shelf exam for that, your current rotation. And then if you're also a clinical student at home, maybe this is a great time to get a leg up on step one or step two CK. So take advantage of this kind of change and opportunity. Kind of try to take a negative, flip it to be a positive, and try to put yourself in a good position to move forward with your medical education and to do well in all these tests, which are going to have kind of a permanent score and impact on your life. So in order to do this, we've actually been working to expand our tutor availability at MedSchoolCoach. Here, we can kind of provide you the support that you need kind of in this really challenging time, provide you the kind of direction and guidance that you need if you have all these questions about how am I supposed to change my plan? When should I take the exam? Should I delay? What is this going to mean for my education? That's really something that we're going to focus really hard on right now, and that we have the tools to provide you with. So we're here for you. We've always been here for students. We think that right now there's a particular need for students who need some digital education, some digital support, and some digital tutoring. So if you're interested in learning more, you can go to medschoolcoach.com. We have everything online. If you would like to schedule a 15-minute phone consult with me, you can go through our enrollment team and they can kind of set that up, and we can talk in game plan about how tutoring might be useful for you and how tutoring can help you move forward and through this particularly challenging time. But we're here for you. Be calm, stay focused, keep your eyes on the prize. Continue through your medical education, put yourself in a position to do better on these exams so you can go on to get that residency that you want and the training that you want. Good luck, be safe, and I'll kind of end with this. I think the road to becoming a physician is very challenging. It's very long, it's arduous. Medical school is difficult. These board exams are so challenging, but being able to gain and utilize all that knowledge to help people when they're ill and when they need you the most is extremely gratifying.